Going to get all kinds of accusations, all kinds of accusations. To put this in perspective, to tie the whole khutbah together, when he speaks to Allah, his eyes are becoming cool. But when he speaks to the people, when he speaks especially to Fir'aun, it is a necessary consequence that the eyes will become warm. It is a necessary, all messengers, when they deal with the people, they hear hurtful things. Even the most respectful of them, the most noble of them. Nuh alayhi salam is talking to the same bunch of people. Now, I like to put things in perspective for you. If one of you got up right now and started cursing me out and my family out, and started calling me all kinds of names, what would I do next? I'd probably drop the mic and get out of here. Let's go, we're leaving. Back to Texas for me. And somebody calls me, hey, when are you coming back to Bayshore? I ain't coming back, is that guy still there? You know that guy who got up and did whatever he did? I'm not coming back until he moves. Do the messengers have that luxury? Some guy gets up and insults the messenger of Allah, he says, that's it, I'm moving to Taif. I'm out of here, off to Medina for me. Does he have that luxury? Does Nuh alayhi salam figure, no, time for the next town. I've overstayed my welcome after one speech. No. The next day he comes back, not even a different crowd, it's the same crowd of people. And if the guy was obnoxious the first day, you can only imagine the next day. And you can only imagine the day after that, he's spending centuries with the same bunch of people. And they get so nasty with him that he walks by and he describes istaghshaw thiyabahum. They pull their clothes in and cover their face like they can't stand his smell, or they'll be disgusted by the fact that he would touch them. They would treat him like that. He doesn't stand there and say, who do you think you're talking to? I'm a messenger of Allah. You don't know what my dua can do. He doesn't do that. He's continuously conversing with the people. Enough reason for anybody's eyes to become warm. Now you're ready for the hadith. The hadith I told you about cooling the eyes. The Messenger of Allah says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, جُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنَيَّ فِي الصَّلَةِ. The coolness of my eyes was placed inside the prayer. When the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stands to make salah, who is he conversing with? Allah. And when he converses with Allah, his eyes become cool. He sheds tears of joy. He regains his strength. He revitalizes and re-energizes. And now that he's re-energized and revitalized, he goes back to give da'wah to the people. And the people say hurtful things that make his eyes warm. Now he has to cool them again. And what does he come back to? The salah. He re-energizes with salah again. The salah is the refuge of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Compare that. Compare a mother losing her child and finding it again, and Allah says her eyes have become cool. And Allah's Messenger says, that coolness of the eyes I find when I make salah. Now compare that salah to your salah and my salah. What has happened since then? For a lot of us, the salah has become an obstacle in our day. It gets in the way. God, it's time again? I have some really other important things to do, and it's kind of, you know, hampering my schedule. I have to pull over for it. Or I'm in the middle of a really important project, and I have to, you know, pause it, hit save, and then go in the copy machine room and make salah and still think about the project while I'm standing. My mind is still there. Just get it over with. A lot of us make salah like hit and run. Right? You hit the floor a couple of times, get out of here. Get it over with. Right? I'm not even talking about the obligation of making salah. I'm talking about the gift that Allah gave to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This was a gift to him. He had a very difficult job and he needed something that would strengthen him. The Messenger was in need of something that would strengthen him. So Allah Azza wa Jal told him in Surah Al-Muzzammil to stand up and pray half the night, or a little less, or a little more. And in the next surah, now that he's regained his strength, يَا أَيُّهَا الْمُدَّثِّرْ قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ. Go and warn. Rise and warn people. Do the other part. Subhanallah. He tells the believers themselves, إِسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَةِ. إِسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ. Seek help from sabr, not only from sabr, from salah. From salah. This is supposed to be something that helps us. This is supposed to be something that cools our eyes. That is what salah is supposed to be. I mentioned all of this for you for two reasons. One, that all of us make a commitment to take better care of this gift that Allah gave us, this prayer, this salah. This is not something trivial. This is something very important. And I wanted to mention one slight side thing about salah before I tell you the second thing I wanted to mention, the concluding thing, is the following. You know when Musa alayhi salam introduced himself to Allah? or Allah introduced himself to Musa alayhi salam, do you think that Musa alayhi salam will ever forget this conversation happened? You meet someone famous, you never forget. He just met with Allah, he spoke with Allah, he's never gonna forget. He will never forget. But even he who will never forget, Allah told him, إِنَّنِي أَنَ اللَّهِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَاعْبُدْنِي وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي. It is I, no doubt, Allah. There is no one to be worshipped and obeyed except myself. Then enslave yourself and worship me. And listen to this part. Establish the salah so you can remember me. The one who will never forget, Allah tells even him, if you really want to remember me, you better establish salah. Salah is the real way to remember me. SubhanAllah. The final thing I wanted to share with you is about da'wah. Is about spreading the message of Islam. One of the purposes of this khutbah is to tell you that what happens in salah is necessarily connected to what happens outside salah. The two things are connected. If your salah has become empty, if your salah has become meaningless, then your da'wah will also become meaningless. The salah is the way you energize and become, you connect to Allah, and you really feel what you appreciate the treasure Allah has given you in this deen. And when you appreciate that treasure, you're able to deliver it to someone else with a genuine sincerity. And when a sincere heart gives da'wah, then Allah puts effect in that da'wah. Otherwise, it's just impressive words. It's just, you know, words on a mic. And you could be impressive with that, but it won't carry any barakah, any effect. If we want our da'wah to really have the oomph, that strength, that energy, then the internal has to be changed, and then the external. And this is the balance Allah Azza wa Jalla gave us in this deen. You concern yourself with your own shortcomings, at the same time you work on the problems of society and declare the message. These are two things that go hand in hand, and you cannot take one and give it priority over the other. They go hand in hand, SubhanAllah. May Allah Azza wa Jalla give us an appreciation of the legacy of all of His messengers, and a newly found love and appreciation, particularly of the sunnah of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and especially of salah. May Allah give us coolness of the eyes from our spouses and our children. Rabbana hab lana min azwajina wa dhurriyatina qurrata a'yunin waj'alna lil muttaqina imama. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil qur'an al hakim wa nafa'ni wa iyyakum bil ayati wa dhikr al hakim. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى خصوصا على أفضلهم وخاتم النبيين محمد الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول الله عز وجل في كتابه الكريم بعد أقول أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. عباد الله رحمكم الله، اتقوا الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا. Move up and squeeze together as much as you can. There are people outside. And head downstairs as well. There's more space.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استقيموا يرحمكم الله make your lungs as straight as you can if you have cell phones please make sure they're turned off الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين هل أتاك حديث الجنود فرعون وثمود بل الذين كفروا في تكذيب والله من ورائهم محيط بل هو قرآن مجيد في لوح محفوظ.